Hello listeners, you're listening to Bangalore's first community radio station, Radioactive CR 90.4 MHz. Get active. And this is RJ Jharna on Preeti's Talk with RJ Jharna.
Preeti's Talk is a platform to speak out your mind. I love to talk to people. I listen though. When I speak to people, I feel every person has something unique to speak out. I thought, let me start this Preeti's Talk to bring out their beautiful mind to the listeners. I invite some special guests here with me who may motivated or inspired me at times. So I thought maybe they will motivate you too. Maybe they can motivate the whole world. So Preeti's Talk is about fitness, empowerment and celebrating womanhood. Today with me, I have a very special guest, Major General Vikram Dev Dogra. He is our pride. He is India's pride. He is the first Major General who had completed world famous Ironman triathlon. He is the only general across the world finish the ruling race in Austria. He redefined fitness. Major General Vikram Dogra cycled from Jodhpur to Jaisalmer, Sela Pass to Bumla Pass in Arunachal Pradesh, Leh to Chandigarh, Akhnu to Rajouri in Jammu and Kashmir. Today we want to listen from him, about his achievement and about his passion. Welcome to Preeti's Talk.
Thank you so much, Preeti, for inviting me to your show. It's indeed my honor and privilege to be here to talk to you all.
Thank you so much. First of all, I want to know, what is the Ironman? Maybe many people know about the Ironman, but there are people still there who don't even know, maybe want to know what is the Ironman actually. So I'd just like to know from you, what is Ironman?
Yeah, that's true. A lot of people don't know what Ironman is. The Ironman is a triathlon of three disciplines, swimming, okay, cycling and running, in that order. Mm-hmm. And the distances are so grueling that it's known as the most grueling one-day endurance event in the world. You have to swim 3.8 kilometers, normally either in the ocean or in the lake. After that, followed by 180 kilometers of cycling, which has an elevation in between maybe from 2,000 to 5,000 feet of elevation which you gain. Followed by a full marathon of 42.2 kilometers, all to be done one after the other in a single day, and to be completed in 17 hours. Oh, and wow. If you do this in 17 hours, you are titled Ironman.
Yes, and I think you have done, I heard that you have done on time, and I mean, it's really, you are really proud of us.
Thank you. I did it in 14 hours and 21 minutes to be precise.
Oh, that's wonderful. So just wanted to know the next thing, how did you, I mean, you know, convince yourself to the Ironman? How did you convince yourself?
So actually, firstly...
And things, why did you do?
Yeah, so I'll take the second question first. Why did I do Ironman? You know, what happens in life is that when you reach a stage where I am in life, when you are nearing your retirement or the end of your career, and your children are settled and things seem to be all going well, you feel that you are moving, but you don't know where you're going. You are on autopilot. Your life is on autopilot. And to coin a word for it, I would say that you are facing midlife crisis. And that's what I was facing, midlife crisis. I wanted to do something that would jolt me out of this slumber of the smooth sailing journey which I had. And then I started looking around to see, find something which was, which would challenge me. Okay. And I found that the Ironman was an event, mm-hmm, which would fit this bill appropriately.
Right. You have a, I mean, I say it's a tough job. You have an office, you have a work, and apart from this also, it's the toughest thing in this world, that being an Ironman, complete triathlon. How did you convince yourself?
So the convincing part is the difficult part, because once you have convinced yourself, then, you have to train for it. But first you have to convince your inner self that you want to do this. So there is a voice, there are two voices always within you, which tells you must do it. Because like I said, I wanted to do something which would shake me out of this smooth sailing. And then there's another voice which is pulling you down and saying, no, you can't do it. That at 58, if you try something like this, you might die. You'll get a heart attack. And you have to shut that bad voice or the bad wolf within you.
Mm-hmm.
So I use a technique called public pledging.
Okay.
And public pledging is a technique where if you inform your friends and your family and those who are close to you that you're going to do the event, then there is some kind of a commitment that you have made to these people. And that sees you through, because if you do not then follow through with your commitment, you are letting them down.
Okay.
So I did this. I informed people. I put it on Facebook. A lot of my friends, you know, smirked at me. You know, I could see that look in their eyes, which said that he's silly doing something like this. And that made my resolve even stronger that I have to do this. And that's how I managed to convince myself to say, yes, I'm going to do the Ironman.
And we are proud of you today. You are really, literally our pride. So while preparing this Ironman, what kind of challenges you had faced?
There are numerous challenges that I had to face. And the biggest challenge I had was that I was working. Mm-hmm. And I had a job which saw me in office from 9 in the morning to 5:30 in the evening. Therefore, anything to do with Ironman training had to be done either before I went to work or after I came back from work, or on weekends. Mm-hmm. Where, you know, in Delhi we follow a 5-day week, so the Saturdays and Sundays were free. So in the morning, I would normally do about 40 minutes to 1 hour of core strengthening and body strengthening exercises at home, and at home because I didn't want to waste that time traveling to a gym and coming back, because to be in office by 9, I had to leave home in time. And so it was time critical. So I would do this in the morning. Mm-hmm. And in the evenings on a working day, okay, I would, out of the 5 working days, I would spend 3 days running.
Okay.
After office hours, come back, change, and then go and start running from maybe 6:30 or 7 in the evening to 10 at night, and then get back home. And the other 2 days I would spend swimming in a similar kind of format.
Mm-hmm.
And I would use weekends, that is Saturday evening, to cycle. I would cycle at night from maybe about 11 to 12 or 12 at night to 6, 7 in the morning, because firstly the temperatures in Delhi are very high.
Yes, right.
It's 43 degrees in summer. The traffic on the roads is quite high too, and therefore it becomes dangerous for you to be able to cycle on the road. You get exposed to all this traffic. So to avoid both these factors, I used to cycle at night. So I would typically cycle through the night on a Saturday and then rest on a Sunday morning to recoup. Because doing 180 kilometers of cycling would take nothing short of 6 to 7 hours. Of course, then after that, going to that location from where you would cycle and coming back. And so that's how I tried to fit it into my daily life.
Right. And see, I feel discipline is in our blood. So do you think discipline can make us fit?
I think if you have to be fit, you have to have discipline.
Okay.
And you have to have self-discipline.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel self-discipline is equal to self-love.
Okay.
If you love yourself,
mm-hmm,
and you want to do something for yourself, then you have to have discipline to do that. For example, there are a lot of people who say, I want to lose weight, but I can't lose weight.
Okay, true.
If you can't lose weight, that means you don't love yourself.
Okay.
Because if you love yourself, then
right,
you will do whatever is required to lose weight.
Right.
So next time that plate of chana bhatura comes to you, self-discipline.
Okay.
Don't go and eat it.
Right.
That's equal to self-love.
But I had, you had, you don't restrict yourself to having some, I mean, you know, you have everything and you say that have and go for workout and, you know, I mean, I had that you don't restrict yourself mostly for eating.
I don't because I'm burning out whatever I'm consuming.
Mm-hmm.
So I, in fact, it was a challenge for me to eat more than I was burning.
Mm-hmm.
I would eat, there was a time when I was eating 12 eggs a day.
Okay.
I would have 300 grams of chicken.
Mm-hmm.
I would have protein shakes, 2 of them. I would have bananas. I would have halwa at night with a lot of ghee in it, so that, you know, I could, otherwise I was losing weight.
Okay.
And I was losing more weight than I wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
So you can eat everything.
So you mean to say, while having food, as well as if you have a proper diet, or maybe sometimes, see, normally we are worried eating ghee. Oh my God, I mean, put on weight. So how you manage that eating, as you say right now, having ghee, maybe, or maybe, you know, chicken, or maybe this way. So how you manage that eating food as well as being fit. See, you know that, na? Nowadays we are, I'm thinking, as a woman, I think, I am worried to have food normally. See, if I have a ghee, I'll put on a lot of weight. So what do you want to say about that?
So you are scared to have fat or fatty food because you'll put on weight because you are not burning that.
Okay.
But if you were to run 10 kilometers every day, 15 mm-hmm. kilometers every day,
mm-hmm.
you eat what you like. You eat ice cream every day, you have all the halwas, you
oh,
have the
wow,
mithais,
this
nothing
is
gonna
wonderful.
Happen. Yes.
Maybe listener will love to listen to you and I mean...
Provided
you, know,
you burn it out. So you have to run and you have to exercise it. You have to burn
right,
it.
It's true. Right. So now I want to know, what fitness mean to you?
Fitness, I think, is integral to everybody's life.
Okay.
They say health is wealth.
Mm-hmm.
People are busy, you know, trying and earning wealth
mm-hmm.
and ignoring their health.
Right.
But for me, health is wealth. Because if you are not fit, if you are not healthy,
mm-hmm.
then all that money that you earn and all the time you spend to do other things have no meaning.
Right. True. So, want to know now, who is your biggest inspiration?
My inspiration was a woman called Iron Nun.
Okay.
She is a nun
mm-hmm.
in the US and her name is Sister Madonna.
Okay.
Today she's 88 years old. But she started running mm-hmm. at 48.
Mm-hmm.
After 4 years, she was introduced to triathlons and at 52, she did her first triathlon.
Okay.
And thereafter, year after year, she's been doing triathlons. She's done 40 Ironman
oh
events so far.
God.
And even now at 88, she's doing a triathlon. She did one recently about 3 to 4 months back.
Oh.
So when I saw her video on YouTube,
mm-hmm.
I was truly inspired
oh.
that if she can do it, then anybody
okay.
can. Anybody should be able to.
Yeah. Not anybody. Mr. Vikram Dev Dogra can definitely do it.
I think anybody can do it. It is meant for an ordinary person. Triathlons, Ironman is meant for any ordinary human being
mm-hmm.
who puts in the commitment, the dedication,
okay.
the practice, the perseverance,
mm-hmm.
and you can do it.
Okay. Thank you so much. So, now I want to know next things. What is your thought about woman emancipation? Woman emancipation.
So I think women emancipation is something which actually should be just part of life. We don't have to have a separate thought about it. But unfortunately in our country, there are many parts of our country where women are not really doing well and they are looked downtrodden and they are, treated indifferently and badly. And therefore this topic of women emancipation. And I think it's a very important aspect in our lives where it is our duty
mm-hmm.
to ensure that women get a platform,
mm-hmm.
women get a status in life, and women are equal partners in this world that we have.
Right. So now, what is your future plan? Like, what you want to do next? So you have done already Austria, you have done. So what is your future plan? What do you like to say?
I have many future plans and they are like dreams. Of course, one is to do another Ironman, which I have homed on to doing the Ironman in Sweden, Kalmar, in August 2019.
Mm-hmm.
But I also have another dream, which is to cycle around the world.
Ooh.
And that cycling around the world will involve moving from Asia to Europe to North America, South America, Australia and back to Asia. So 5 continents spanning something like about 22,000 to 29,000 kilometers.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I want to do.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's nice. That's all. I mean, my loads of wishes for that. Now I want to know, see, you are running continuously, you are doing Ironman, you have done. I want to know, what kind of, like, when I'm running, me, I am also a runner, but not able to do more than 10 kilometers. As of now, I have done only 10 kilometers. So, I feel like tired maybe after that, or like, how to increase my speed, or maybe, you know, the running kilometer distance, how to. You want to give us some, fastest runner, the small runner, or maybe slow runner. Do you want to give some tips?
Well, the biggest tip is practice.
Okay.
So there is no shortcut to hard work.
Okay.
So you have to run and you have to practice.
Okay.
And if you're running 10 kilometers,
mm-hmm.
then you must slowly increase the distance to 11 kilometers. And then once you're comfortable, to 12 kilometers.
Okay.
So you make make your goals according to where you want to reach. So if your goal is to, say, do a half Ironman, a half marathon and 21.1 kilometers and you are at 10, then slowly keep adding a kilometer to it. As you go along, maybe 1 kilometer every week or 1 kilometer every fortnight. That depends upon how much time you have to spare and can work. But there is no shortcut to hard work.
Okay.
So one, of course, is this practice. And secondly is to do body strengthening. You need to do core strengthening, strengthening of your legs and your entire body so that you can sustain and carry out this activity for the duration it's going to be. So 10 kilometers would probably say if it takes you 1 hour, then 21.1 kilometers will take you 2 hours plus. And therefore, your body should be able to sustain it.
Right.
So you need to work both on your cardio and on your body strength.
So when you have done your first Ironman, anyway, I know that you are going to do a lot of things again in future also. When you have done your first Ironman, how you prepared? Like you have taken some special coach or maybe special training. How have you have prepared for yourself?
So there is really not many coaches available in India because triathlons in India are relatively new. You have people who give you advice on running, but triathlon is a different ball game. And the coaches who are available are in a few cities. And I personally felt that I don't need a coach. I can read about what I need to do, how I need to prepare. So I took no coach. I did a lot of research. I did a lot of study on running, swimming, cycling, how to combine transitions, nutrition, hydration. I did my own research, and I don't think I was lacking in any way.
That's really wonderful. So now, do you want to give what you want to say about my listener, our listener? What you want to give as a tips? Maybe sometime as a small tips, maybe what kind of shoes, maybe what kind of socks you want to wear, or maybe before the run, what precaution you have to take, or maybe what food do you have to take? Like, do you want to say anything about that?
Yeah, there are actually hundreds and hundreds of tips. And the list is endless, but I'll give a few tips. Firstly, when you buy, say, let's start with shoes. When you buy your shoes, since you're going to be running, the weight of the shoes, apart from, of course, the comfort and the flexibility and the breathability of the shoe, the weight is very important because every extra gram that you carry on your feet tire your legs. So you must buy shoes which are not only comfortable to wear but also which are light. Secondly, you have to do with your socks. The socks should be so well fitting, and you have something called performance socks. There are compression socks which you wear for practice, and then similar kind of socks called performance socks which you wear only on the day you perform. And they fit so snugly in your feet that they don't allow any blisters to come. So it's important to have a good pair of socks. Thereafter, before you start, it's important to warm up. Because when you start warmed up and you start your marathon, you don't shock your heart. You don't start running suddenly and from zero your heart is now suddenly starting to race up to whatever beats per minute that you know your heart would go up to. So it's very important to warm up. So I think these are few of the tips which are there, but there are endless number of tips.
Maybe want to know more tips from you, how they can contact you. How they want to, if suppose I want to regularly want to know tips from you, how I will reach you, how I will contact you.
You can contact me and you can ask me what tips are required, and it will be my pleasure to.
So where
talk
are
to
you
people.
Available? Like you are there in Facebook?
I'm on Facebook. I have a page on Facebook called Vikram Dogra Iron Man. I'm on Instagram. I'm on WhatsApp. I'm there.
Right.
So anybody who wants to...
So whenever I need next time tips, definitely going to disturb you a lot.
Yeah, surely. It'll be my pleasure to do so.
Right. So what you want to say, today you are with Preeti on Preeti's talk. We are discussing, normally this talk is about fitness, about woman empowerment, about celebrating womanhood. So what do you want to talk about Preeti's show?
I think Preeti's show is a unique show. Okay. It uplifts women problems and emancipation of women, which I've already said is very, very important and essential in our, not only in our country, but in, across the world,
right.
Because women deserve their rightful place in society.
Right.
So I think this kind of a show will do wonders for improving the lot of our women.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Thank you for being with me today.
Thank you so much for your lovely talk, sir. I got inspiration from you. Yes, it was lovely hearing you. So, yeah, today we had with us Vikram Dev Dogra. And next episode, we may have someone very special again to inspire you.
I promise. Definitely, I'll give you an opportunity to get somebody who is very special.
Yes. Thank you so much, Preeti, for calling Vikram, sir. Thank you again. Keep listening to Radioactive CR 90.4 megahertz. Get active. Bangalore's first community radio station, and this is